I've always wanted to know, what would it look like to pass through a solid object with another solid object? I would imagine it would look something like this. And even though this is just an illusion, I did find a way to make a solid object pass through another solid object, and it doesn't have to be a trick, and I'm about to show you how. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey guys, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic. Now today's topic on Impossible Science is solid objects passing through solid objects, and what you just saw was a total illusion. But that doesn't mean it's impossible. In fact, I'm gonna show you how to make a solid object pass through a solid object at your house, and it won't be a trick. You won't need any magic glassware, but you will need a coaster, and some paper, and an alternate dimension. No, seriously, you'll need another dimension to do this. Check this out. Okay, take a close look at this one, because we're about to pass this coaster through that tiny square. And it won't be a trick. That's right, this coaster, which is larger than the diagonal in this square and larger than the square itself, we're about to pass this coaster through that square with the help of geometry. And a few magic folds, I'll show you. We can now take this coaster and we can actually get it to pass through that square hole. And we never tore the paper. So how's it work? There's a few characteristics that come up when you're talking about a circle. Sometimes you'll hear the term circumference. Well, that's the distance if you were to travel all the way around a circle. There's a diameter. That's the distance you would travel if you went from one side of the circle to the other side of the circle through the center point. And then there's the radius. The radius is the distance from the center point to the edge. It's also good to know that the radius is half the distance of the diameter. That's gonna come up in just a little bit. And this square is not just any square. This is a square that we calculated. Now, what does that mean? It means we're gonna take measurements from our circle and we're gonna use it to cut that square. In this case, let's take a measurement of the diameter of our coaster. If you don't have a coaster, look for a lid to a jar in the kitchen. All right, in this case, let's take a measurement. The diameter is 4 inches, which means the radius is 2 inches, half the distance of the diameter. And we're gonna use that radius to make our square. That's right, each side, each length and width of the square is gonna be 2 inches on my square. Now, if you have a different diameter on your circle at home, your radius will be the distance you will need to make your square. Okay, we have our square, we have our circle. So how's it work? Well, the cool news is this square is trapped in a two-dimensional space. What does that mean? Well, it means it only has 2 dimensions, length and width. But we live in a 3-dimensional world, so we can take advantage of that. That's right. See, what happens is, because it's trapped in 2D, the longest point is the diagonal. But we have a trick up our sleeves. We have the 3rd dimension. So I'll show you what I mean. If we take this piece of paper and we fold into the 3rd dimension, that's right, we're giving height, and we line up that diagonal with our fold. Now, here comes the tricky part. We're gonna take these two sides and we're gonna fold them till they're flat. And what I mean by that is we're gonna take this section right here and we're gonna bow it up into that 3rd dimension, into the height. And by doing that, we can actually pivot everything around that corner. See that? And I can fold that right there. Now, when we made this square, we made the distance from this point to this point the radius of our coaster. So when I bend these together, 2 radii equal the diameter of that coaster. I fold it over across its side like this, and it'll look like this. If you were to open it right now, you'd realize this flap is in your way. So all you have to do is take this flap and move it over so that you get a clear hole with that square. So I can take this circle, place it inside there, and it will pass through because square we made, 2 radii equal the diameter. And there you have it. We didn't tear the square at all. Pretty magical if you think about it. Well, that's it for today. We just took an illusion of a solid object passing through a solid object, and we made it real by thinking about geometry in another dimension. So have fun with it, try out different shapes around the house, and never forget about that extra dimension, because it's a tricky one. Well, if you had fun today, let me know by clicking the like button and subscribing to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.